Morning, West Valley. My name is Henry Rice, bringing you the weather, bringing you the news for today. The weather for today is a high of 70 and a low of 40. Today, for lunch, you can get sweet chili Thai chicken and a rice bowl, stuffed crust, cheese and pepperoni pizza, mini chef salad with ham and a roll, side item, curly fries, green beans, Caesar salad, and veggie nibbles. For dessert, you can get a chocolate chip or sugar cookie. Attention all current 6th and 7th grade students. Applications for taking advanced art next year are due by March 10th at midnight. Okay, now for Sophie's side of the story.
Good morning, Miss Valley. I'm Sophie Service, back with another book. This week's book is My Side of the Mountain, where at 12 years old, Sam, the main character, decides it would be a good idea to make a home and live in the Catskill Mountains, which is actually a real place located in New York, I found out. His dad decided that it was okay and thought he would come back in the next hour because Sam brought nothing with him, not even a penny. On the other hand, Sam was more serious than his dad. First, Sam made a whole entire house with only items in the wood that he found. Gotta give him props for that. Then he learned to fish, hunt, and gather, trying his hardest to survive in the unpredictable wilderness he lives in. One day, in the middle of winter, while Sam was hunting for his food, he found a baby eagle who fell off a small cliff. Okay, I'm going to be honest with you. The first time I read this, I closed the book at this part because I thought Sam was going to eat the baby eagle. But I came back to this book later and found out that he actually kept him as a pet. He even named him Frightful because of the frightful experience they encountered together. Sam teaches Frightful to fly, eat, and obviously they become best of friends. One day, a hunter comes to Sam's side of the mountain, shoots some prey, and never retrieves it. So Sam claims it. Little does he know, the hunter in the forest saw him and reported him to the news. So the question is... So the question is, does Sam get found out, or does this, or, oh my gosh, bring it together.
It's all good.
Okay, so the question is, does Sam get found out, or does his existence remain a secret? My favorite quote from the story is, I must say something about the first campfire. It was magic. Out of dead tinder and grass and sticks came warm light. It cracked and snapped, smoked with filled... It cracked and snapped and smoked and... This guy who wrote this worded this part so weird. It cracked and snapped and smoked and filled the woods with brightness. It lighted the trees and made them warm and friendly. It stood tall and bright and held back the night. Overall, I would rate this book a 3 out of 5 because, like, for, like, 4 chapters, I said to myself, that was a really unnecessary chapter and I'm not even sure why it's in there. That being said, I have definitely read worse books, and you'll probably love this book if you like thrills and adventure. That's just my side of the story.
Thanks, Sophie.
Hey, Daddy.
Hey, son.
You got any food for this long car trip?
I'm ready to find some almonds here.
Wow, thanks. Wow, thanks, Daddy. Did you know today is National Almond Day? Did you know that almonds are related to peaches? They can also be turned into milk. They're great for the heart, and they're also a great energy booster.
Oh, that's great, son.
Wow, those are good. No wonder they're made with 24 grams of total fat, 2 grams of saturated fat, 6 grams of polyuccinated fat, 15 grams of monosaccharide fat, 130 milligrams of sodium, and 7 grams of total carbohydrate.
Wow, son, can I have an almond?
Sure, Dad. Dad, aren't you supposed to be focusing on the road right now?